Good afternoon mga ka-HR! Isang magandang-magandang hapon po sa lahat. Na-miss nyo po ba ang HR Calabarzon HR e-knowledge? Siyempre, medyo nagpahinga tayo ng 2 weeks kasi talaga namang ginagawa natin ang paraan o inaayos natin ang mga requirements sa atin at mga request. At dahil may request po sa atin this afternoon, talaga namang sa dahil dumarami na. Dumarami na po ang... Parang nakalimutan na nga ang millennial. Millennial, Gen Z, boomer, ang dami na. So parang this afternoon talaga namang magiging topic natin ang how we could understand the worker or the HR to generation. So para iba-iba. Ako po kasi ay Gen X po ata ako. Ata, may ata pa. Pero dahil dyan, tayo po. Yes, hi Sir Randolph. Good afternoon po. Good afternoon, Ma'am Mitch. Good afternoon po kay Ma'am Melanie. Good afternoon po sa ating mga ka-HR dyan, kay Ma'am Joy, kay Ma'am Kimberly. At sa mga hindi pa po naka-online, please do online o join us in Zoom. 100 po ang ating pwedeng ma-accommodate this afternoon. Kaya join na po kayo. And I'm now sharing my... Yan. So para po sa kaalaman ng lahat, ngayon po ay nasa 10,000 members na po tayo. And ilang tulog na lang, third year anniversary na natin para sa ating founding day, which is on March 4, 2020. At dahil anniversary natin sa March 4, mayroon po akong announcement mamaya. Okay, what is HR Calabarzon? HR Calabarzon is a registered non-profit organization which provide virtual and soon face-to-face learning to all HR practitioner and enthusiasts in Calabarzon, Cavite, Laguna, Batangas, Rizal, and Quezon. So sa mga gusto pong mag-request o mag-avail ng e-certificate dahil gusto nila kaming matulungan na makapagbigay ng free learning sa lahat ng mga HR, especially sa mga HR student, mga HR and psychology student. Ang lahat po ay pwedeng maka-access o makakuha ng e-certificate link o makita ang e-certificate link until 11:59 p.m. Today lang po, today. Hindi na po kami mag-extend hanggang ngayong araw lang po available ang ating link. Ang e-certificate po ay may papadala sa inyo after 2 working days. Hindi po kasama ang Saturday and holiday. So kung kukumpit po natin yon, ito po ay may papadala sa inyo sa Wednesday next week. Nakikiusap po kami na please ensure the Google form was accurately filled up. Lalo na po ang ating first name, middle initial, and last name. Initial po sana para po madali pong ma-email merge ang inyong mga pangalan. Lalo na po ang ating mga email address. Minsan po nagba-bounce back kasi mali-mali po ang spelling natin sa ating email address. How much is the minimal fee? The minimal fee is 50 pesos per attendee per webinar. Note po, we do not entertain e-certificate requests via email nor messenger for auditing purposes. And ang ating GCash payment o ang ating cellphone number para sa GCash is 0919-009-6339. Please do screenshot our QR code. We are inviting everyone to join the Certified Compensation and Benefit Professional Cohort 13 on February 24 to 25, 2023. Please do register at www.ihri.ph/ccbp-register. Ayan, join po kayo dyan. Nag-join po ako dyan, mga ka-HR. Please also join our weekly Saturday, the HR Cafe, Trabaho, Buhay, at iba pa with the Philippine HR Group. Every Sunday po yan, alas 3 ng hapon. Next week, watch out for Manda B. Granville 2. Another HRE knowledge entitled How to Enrich multi-generational relationship at work today. Medyo may connect po siya sa today's webinar natin with HR e-knowledge. Ayan, ito po yung sinasabi ko. We are inviting everyone for the first face-to-face HR Business Partner Learning Series of 2023 with Ma'am Vivian. Ayan po, iniimbitahan po namin kayo sa March 4 sa lahat ng mga taga Cavite, Imus, Bacoor, Dasma, Gentry, GMA, Silang, ano ba yung mga taga Cavite? Please join us this March 4, our first face-to-face HR Business Partner Learning Series. Ito po ay magaganap on 8:30 to 5:30 p.m. in Dasmariñas City. Pwede pong magbago yung venue ng IMUS dahil meron pong isang nag-o-offer sa amin ng school na pwede pong i-accommodate ang ating face-to-face HR Business Partner Learning Series. Ito po ay paid. Bayad po ito. At ang ating pong pag-uusapan is the role of an HR, the HR Business Partner and its focus, organization's diagnostic tool, driving and managing change, HR analytics, and introduction. Kaya sana po makasama namin kayo. At dahil lahat po ay mag-a-attend ng face-to-face HR, paid face-to-face HR Business Partner, magkakaroon din po tayo ng free. Ayan, free naman po. Free face-to-face HR Student Learning Series of 2023. Sa lahat po ng mag-a-attend ng March 4, sorry, hindi ko lang po napalitan yung date. Sa lahat po ng mag-a-attend ng March 4, ang inyo pong payment ay mai-donate po o maibibigay po ito para ma-accommodate po natin ang one whole day face-to-face HR Student Learning Series 2023. Sa ngayon po ay naghahanap pa po kami ng school na pwedeng mag-accommodate sa amin at sa mga HR and psychology student na gustong umattend ng mangyayaring face-to-face HR Student Learning Series of 2023. Ang ating pong topic is the role of HR, 8 hours of HR, the employee's journey, competency-based system, Philippines labor relation affecting pay and benefits, and managing employee discipline. Inisip po namin ito with Ma'am Vivian Cruz para po mabigyan ang ating mga ka-HR student ng talagang mangyayari kapag sila ay pumasok na sa real corporate world. Kaya magkita-kita tayo mga ka-HR student yan. PM-PM na po dahil talaga namang para po ito sa inyo for free. Sa mga sponsor naman po na gusto po kaming tulungan na mapatupad po itong free face-to-face HR Student Learning Series, please, we are open for collaboration. And we would like to to thanks the following sponsor, PC Works Infinite Possibilities. If may kailangan po kayo mga gadget, ka-anniversary lang po nila, isa po sila sa kilala na nagbibigay o tumutulong sa ating mga ka-HR para mabigyan ng mabibilis at updated na mga gadgets para sa school. We would like to thank also Wellness Health and Total Rewards Insurance Consultant for quotation requests, product presentation, and inquiries. You may contact our employee benefit consultant or email us at ed@wellnesshealthandtotalrewards. Please do screenshot the contact number of Mr. Dion Jeffrey and Mr. Raymond Austria. Also, we would like to thank Butterfly Kitty Salon. Get your girls ready for unlimited makeover. Kaya tayo mga nanay, may mga anak, totoong mga anak talaga tayo na kung sakaling magkaroon ng kanilang mga birthday celebration, please do contact us. Meron po tayong hair and makeup, nail art, face painting, meron din po tayong glitter tattoo. Please do contact Miss Ludilin Australia at 0936-628-6487. Ayan. Nakikisuyo po kami at nakikiusap sa lahat ng participant na please camera or video on while in session or is in progress. Please mute the microphone when not talking. Use chat box to express ideas or question. Raise your hand to be recognized. Makikita naman po namin yan with my, syempre, katuwang na volunteer, Ma'am Mitch Hipolito. At syempre, makikita rin po ng ating speaker this afternoon. Ang ating speaker ay isa sa kilala na speaker mentor ng Philippine HR Group. At siya rin po ay may-ari o managing director ng Talent Search Reach Consulting. Si Sir Ronald F. Turla po ay naimbitahan ng HR Calabarzon para itakel ang understanding workforce based on generation. Kasi even me, marami po kami mga employees na iba-ibang generation. May boomerang, may Gen X, may Gen Z, may millennial. At talaga naman pong halos lahat sa ating mga ka-HR ay nahihirapan. Pero bago natin tawagin ang ating speaker this afternoon, ipakilala natin siya. Mr. Ronald Turla, or he is a sought-after certified coach on emotional intelligence for Institute for Social and Emotional Intelligence, the leading institution of EQ assessment tools based in Denver, Colorado, USA. Wow, sana ka-green makarating doon. As a certified human resource professional with over 15 years in human resource management or organization development, Sir Ronnie has occupied managerial position in several companies from different industry, such as 7-Eleven, the convenience store market leader, Yellow Cab, a well-known and famous pizza brand, and 24/7 Customer Philippines, a call center company where he handled almost 900 agents. Ang dami nun. Nakakalula. He runs his own management consultancy service company, Talent Reach, which primarily caters to growing small to medium enterprise. He's a regular speaker for Ariba Events Management. He's also an ambassador for International Federation of Professional Managers, IFPM, which carries the Global Human Resource Certification, CHRP, here in the Philippines. Mr. Turla has authored a book entitled The HR Compass, which is now distributed in major bookstores nationwide. He has also been a speaker for various conferences such as Talents Management Asia 2020, Learning and Development Asia 2018, and the HR Congress 2019. Umattend po ako niyan. He has also recently been given a distinction of a fellow from the International Federation of Professional Managers for his hard work and dedication to the HR profession. Guys, mga ka-HR, let's all welcome our speaker mentor for today. Na talaga namang overwhelmed po ako dahil binigyan niya tayo ng pagkakataon na mag-talk for free. Guys, Mr. Ronaldo F. Turla.
Wow, thank you, Neddy, for a very hearty introduction. Maraming salamat, ano? So, thank you also for inviting me over today, no, for this session. And from an HR to another HR, no? So sabi nga natin, I'm always open to, as long as my schedule permits me to do so, because I'm also involved in training, no, every now and then, even weekends, no. Pero nung nag-chat sa akin si Neddy, sabi ko, I couldn't say no. Sabi ko, I know that Neddy is a fellow HR, and sabi ko nga, I've been in the field, no, for the longest time. That's why for me importante na marunong tayong makisama, no, pagdating sa kapwa natin HR. So yun ang isang bagay na natutunan ko over the years, no. That's why if I can do something, even if it's free, no, and of course my heart is always to help out, especially based on sa sinabi ni Neddy kanina that some of you are students or probably some are psychology graduates, no. By the way, no, kung hindi nabanggit, I'm also a psychology graduate, no, from De La Salle university, no? So yan. So that's why psych is my background talaga. That's why when I entered, no, HR, that was the, you know, that was the time na talagang for us na nasa psychology, no, we were really eyeing to be the HR of the HR department ng mga companies before, no? Matagal na 'yon. Matagal, medyo matagal ng panahon, ano? Yung pag-uusapan natin doon. But again, today we have a very interesting topic which is I think relevant for every one of us kasi sabi nga natin, yung topic is about generation. So ibig sabihin everyone is included, no? So lahat tayo meron tayong pwedeng matutunan in the different generations. Yeah. So yun yung pag-uusapan natin for today, no? So I'm going to present how we can try to understand, no, the generations, oh sorry, understand the workforce through the generational differences, no? So even ako, no, when I encountered the topic, sabi ko, am I the right person to talk about it, no? Because to be honest, no, I have seen, no, generations, no. By the way, I am a Gen Xer, no? So Gen X ako. So in this case, kung ano man yung sasabihin ko today, rest assured, bias ako dahil Gen X ako, sabi nga natin. Okay? But of course, I will try to, as much as possible, no, try to consider yung ating different perspectives sa generation. No? So, what I'm going to offer to you are really my thoughts, no, at the same time, what's happening in the world right now in terms of the generation. And of course, part of this talk, mas gusto ko kasi rin sa akin na there will be questions, no, na pwede nating pag-usapan more than ako lang yung magsasalita, no. Gusto ko na may mga questions sa yung pag-usapan mamaya as a result of this topic. Okay? Ayan. So I will try to make my talk siguro at the most, no, mga 1 hour or so lang, no, para we can try to have questions also. Kasi I know that I think the audience is HR. That's why you know, I'm ready to answer questions, especially mga HR related questions. Ayan. Okay, so let me start my presentation, ano? So yan. So when we talk about yung workforce generation, or the workforce itself by generations, alam natin na this is a very challenging time, no? Because it has been predicted actually na by 2020, which is actually, we've already gone past it. Ibig sabihin, tapos na yung 2020. It has been predicted that by 2020, 5 generations will actually occupy the workplace. So, ibig sabihin, nangyayari na siya today. No? Ibig sabihin, in companies nowadays, makikita natin that companies are composed of different generations. And that, again, poses really a challenge for a lot of us, no, especially for HR. No, that's why I know that this is a very interesting topic, no, because all of us, whether we are HR, we are people managers, for example, lahat tayo meron tayong challenges and struggles pagdating sa understanding the generation. So today, I'm going to try and attempt to provide you with some explanation or some insight kung paano nga ba natin maiintindihan yung bawat isa, no? Especially since we're in the workplace right now and we have differences, no, that we need to understand. Ayan. So for today, for this short session that we're going to conduct, ito yung mga ilan sa mga pag-uusapan natin, ano? So number one, we're going to look at the characteristics and gain a better understanding of the millennials, no? Because for me, ito yung start ng sabi niya natin, we needed to understand other generations, no? Another thing is, we'd also like to find out how we can improve communications and teamwork, you know, in the workplace. And also, we need to also learn how to accept personal responsibility in working together, no? And in my talk today, I'm going to end with some tips and suggestions on how we can manage and motivate millennials, no? So take note lang, no, since we're talking about parang the term millennials, no, I'm talking about not just millennials but the other generations kasi marami ng generations after. Okay, so I hope that in this talk I should be able to give you some highlights, no? So as mentioned kanina, if you heard in the introduction, I am a certified emotional intelligence trainer and coach, no? And for me, I recognize, no, that every person comes from a different generation. That's why iba-iba rin tayo talaga ng perspective, no? That's why for me, it's important that we become knowledgeable, no, about the characteristics of each generation. Okay? Now, alam natin that the war for talent is upon us, no? Ibig sabihin, companies are experiencing the war for talent. So what does it mean? The war for talent means that ang importante ngayon for the current generation is our company culture, no? Ibig sabihin, when they enter into a company, ang tinitingnan nila is talagang culture natin, no? So nowadays, it's not about it's not just about the money, no? It's all about, again, having that kind of relationship inside the organization, no? Now, here are some important things that we should remember, no? So managers today, no, madalas sila meron silang complaint about managing millennials, no? Yet, kung titingnan natin, studies will show that millennials differ little from previous generations. So I think this is, you know, one of the breaking news, no? Ang differences lang that exist, no, creates actually an opportunity for HR to enhance their performance. So ibig sabihin, some of the things na ine-expect nung aking generation, which is the Gen X, no? Ito rin yung actually, no, ine-expect, no, ng current generation. Now, base sa, you know, recent studies, no, lumalabas, no, this is a research study that was done, lumalabas na malaking factor yung role ng isang manager para mas maging engaged yung ating employee. Okay? Sabi nga doon sa pag-aaral, parang lumalabas na no, equally impactful yung relationship ng employee doon sa kanyang asawa or spouse, no? So imagine, for example, kumbaga, kung ikaw ay married person, no, yung relationship mo with your boss or your manager, no, malaki yung impact, halos kasing laki yung impact nung naging kapartner mo sa buhay. Bakit? Kung makikita natin, malaking impact dahil most of the time, we are actually at work, di ba? So that's why, sabi nga natin, kailangan maging maganda yung relationship natin doon sa mismong workplace, no? So, millennials nowadays are quite naturally entrepreneurial, no? So they would like to leverage yung kanilang ability, no, within the organization, no? And then they'd want to benefit from creativity and innovation. Okay. Now, ang millennials natin are normally those who are born from 1982 to 2000, no? So there's about 75 million. Wow. Diba? 75 million, parang almost 80 million na nga yata, no? And these millennials are yung mga parents nila were very involved with them, and your prosperity has increased over their lifetime. So ibig sabihin, marami na nangyari over the period of time from 1982 to the year 2000, no? Most millennials are very achievement oriented kung titingnan natin, ano? And most of them also prefer instant or text messaging, no? And ang isang maganda sa millennials, they are very experts in multitasking. Ayan. So ano yung mga common values ng ating mga tinatawag nating millennials? So here are some characteristics. Ayan. So kung mapapansin nyo, marami ring magagandang characteristics yung makikita natin pagdating sa mga millennials, no? Ayan. Now, isa pang characteristics ng millennials in the workplace, no? I don't know if you will agree with this, no? So titingnan natin ano yung mga characteristics niya. Ang mga millennials in the workplace, task-oriented, no? They want options and choices. Also, they expect attention from their bosses. And of course, expect feedback. Okay? That's why kung meron mga nakikinig dito ng mga managers na Gen X, for example, so take note kung ano yung nakikita natin characteristics ng mga millennials natin. Because remember, no, millennials are the future managers, no? They're, some of them are already the managers of the different organizations, no? So sila na yung next generation who will be the leaders of the organization. Okay? And kung titingnan natin, ang millennials also things digital. Okay? Kasi sila na yung papunta doon sa year 2000. No? And they try to work towards weekend or closing time. Hindi sila mahiling magtrabaho during weekends. No? They are impatient, but they also want to be led. No? So, kaya kung titingnan natin, ano, different characteristics yung ating mga millennials in the workplace. No? Now, let's try to really differentiate yung mga different generations. No? So, tingnan natin to. This is a very interesting table to look at. No? So, ano ba yung mga characteristics? So, kung titingnan natin, pagdating sa job strength, no? Of course, yung mga traditionals, these are the ones na talagang siguro ito na yung mga seniors natin right now, no? They'd want a stable job, no? During their time, no? Now, yung mga baby boomers naman, yung kanilang job strength is that they're very service-oriented and they're team players, okay? Now, for the Gen X, most of them are adaptable and technology literate. So, ibig sabihin, alam na nila kung ano yung nangyayari in terms of technology. While the millennials, kung titingnan natin, they're multitaskers and, of course, they're very savvy. Okay? So, para sa akin, ano, believe ako sa mga millennials because para sa akin, sila talaga yung mas nakakaalam sa bagong technology. Okay? Pagdating naman sa outlook, no, kung titingnan natin yung traditional, it's very practical. Ang mga baby boomers are optimistic, probably because ito yung mga, the baby boomers are normally our parents, no? So, yung boomers are normally the parents of the Gen Xers, no? So, they're quite optimistic, sabi, no? Bakit? Kasi optimistic sila because somehow, no, they've gone through difficult times and somehow, no, na-build na yung kanilang optimism na kahit na maraming problema, no, somehow, no, they will try to get past it, no? Now, for Gen Xers, I would say we're quite skeptical. Okay? So, kumbaga, marami na tayong experience as well. But for the millennials, the good thing is that ang outlook nila, they're hopeful. Okay? Now, pagdating naman sa view of authority, ang traditional, medyo respectful talaga. No? So, yan talagang I would say, I can attest because I've seen, you know, our grandparents, for example, that talagang malaki sa kanila, yung malaking bagay sa kanila yung respeto. No? Now, for the baby boomers, no, their view of authority is they can love or they can hate, no, yung kanilang immediate superior in terms of authority. No? Now, for Gen Xers, makikita natin, they're unimpressed and unintimidated. Okay? Pagdating sa authority. That's why most of our generations, for example, pag may mga pinapatupad na mga rules and regulations, no, we don't want to be intimidated kasi we want to be free, no, in terms of authority. Now, for millennials, no, makikita natin medyo polite, no, ang view nila sa authority. Okay. Now, another interesting, no, in terms of on-the-job strengths, tignan nyo yung leadership. Okay. So, sa leadership, ang traditional, ang paniwala nila, hierarchy. Okay? Kumbaga, yung parang different levels organization ang tingin nila sa leadership. No? Yung mga baby boomers naman, no, by consensus, kung sino yung more or less merong leadership capacity, no, by consensus, sila yung nagiging leader. No? Now, for the Gen Xer, I would attest to this na leadership should be by competence. So, ibig sabihin, the most competent in the workplace, sila yung nagiging leader. Okay? While for the millennial, kung titignan natin, yung leadership is by pulling together or yung tinatawag nating teamwork. Okay? Now, for relationship, no, for traditionals, no, makikita natin, personal sacrifice ang ginawa nila in terms of the job. No? For baby boomers, more of personal gratification pagdating sa relationship. No? For Gen Xers naman, they're reluctant to commit. Okay, kung titingnan natin. While for millennial, medyo mas inclusive na. Okay? So makikita natin, ano, as the generation goes on, makikita natin nagbabago yung perspective. Okay? Now, let's look further, no? Ito pa yung iba pang characteristic pagdating sa different generations. Sa time on the job, no, pagtitingnan natin, yung traditional, of course, punching by the clock, no? Ito alam na alam natin yung body clock for the traditional. Ang mga baby boomers, visibility is key, no? Or yung face time, no? Sabi nga natin. For the Gen Xers, ang gusto naman natin in terms of time on the job, as long as I get the job done, who cares, di ba? Ayan. For millennial, no, it's quitting time. I know I have a real life to live. So ang millennial kasi gusto nila nung tinatawag nating work-life balance na tinatawag. That's why gusto nila may personal life, merong professional life, no? Ayan. So yun yung ano, yun yung pagkakaiba. Sa diversity naman, traditionals medyo ethnically segregated. Sa baby boomers, may integration, no? Sa pagdating naman sa Gen Xers, sa diversity, medyo integrated na. Ibig sabihin parang in terms of diversity, mas tanggap na natin, no? And for millennials, walang majority race. Ibig sabihin, walang mas magaling na race, no? Kahit na Amerikano ka or from another country ka, no? Hindi ibig sabihin mas magaling ka sa amin, no? I have my own strengths, no, na pwede kong gamitin. Okay? So that's something about diversity. Now, for feedback, kung titingnan natin, for traditional, sabi dito, no news is good news, no? Ayaw natin ng mga chismis, sabi nga natin, no? For baby boomers naman, once a year with documentation. So gusto ng mga baby boomers na at least kausapin mo sila once a year, no? Para sabihin sa kanila kung kamusta ba yung trabaho nila, no? While for Gen Xers, no? Yung feedback pwedeng i-interrupt yung employee and ask how they're doing. So mas gusto nila yon na very spontaneous, sabi nga natin, no? For millennial, they would want feedback at the push of a button. So gusto nila instant din, no? So medyo similar yung sa feedback pagdating sa Gen Xers tsaka sa millennial. Okay. Now, pagdating sa work-life balance, makikita natin for traditional, no, they need help shifting, no? While for baby boomers, no, balance everyone and also themselves, no? Balance ng trabaho at yung personal life, no? While for Gen Xers, kung titingnan natin, gusto nila na magkaroon ng balance rin. Okay? For millennials more so, no, they need flexibility to balance their activities. So, yan ang mga different characteristics ng on-the-job strengths ng different generation. Diba? So, kung titingnan natin, no, these characteristics will definitely help us understand yung ating mga different generations. Okay? So, I hope, no, na itong binigay ko sa inyong sample, no, na comparison ng different generations, makatulong sa atin para mas maintindihan natin yung ating different generations, no? Now, again, kung titingnan natin, no, in terms of yung mga characteristics in the workplace, no, iba-iba rin talaga tayo ng characteristics from the baby boomers, no, who were born from 1963, no? Ang Gen X, 1963 to 1980. Ayan. Which, of course, kasama na ako dito, no? Kasama na ako dito sa generation na to. And of course, you have the millennials, no? Ayan. Now, ito yung mga dapat nating tatandaan pagdating sa managing and understanding other generation. Okay? In terms of managing and motivating, we need to provide a strong and involved management. Importante yan pagdating sa organization, no? Another thing that is very common as a current generation, they'd want to connect their work to a higher purpose. Ibig sabihin, dapat yung ginagawa nila hindi lang para kumita ng pera. Dapat meron ding nagagawa tayo not just for ourselves but also for other people. Okay? Another thing is that for millennials and Gen Z na tinatawag, we have to make recognition impactful. Okay? Kasi more and more, pag tinignan natin yung current generation, malaking factor sa kanila yung recognition, no? Another is they'd want to make work challenging, they'd want to make work engaging, and they wanted to make it fun. Okay? Ayaw nila na masyadong seryoso pag titingnan natin. Okay? And of course, to manage and motivate the current generations, we have to leverage modern technology. And ako, no, bilang isang Gen Xers, I always have to remind myself na kung ano yung better approach, especially pagdating sa technology, no, I have to be open to it, no? Of course, kasi yung generation ko, we have a tendency sometimes na kung ano yung nakasanayan na natin, yun yung laging ginagawa natin. But, you know, for the new generation, no, they know the technology, they know the modern technology, that's why we have to be open to such technology. Now, pagtitingnan natin in terms of providing, no, strengths to the man, Kung titingnan natin, one company have discovered that millennials could be very could actually become the most productive generation, no? Kasi sabi nga natin, sila na talaga yung majority in the workplace, no? Malaking population nila right now in the workplace, no? That's why for them, para ma-motivate sila, kailangan i-consider natin itong mga bagay na to. Number one, no, dapat meron tayong limitless thinking. Meaning, no, they believe that they can achieve their goals and their dreams. Okay? And we have to help them. No? Also, high expectations. No? So, wanting more from a job rather than just getting a paycheck. No? And of course, sabi nga natin, they're very tech savvy. They have grown up with games, social media, videos. No? So, gusto nila na magkaroon ng desire to make an impact to other people. Okay? Now, yung sinabi natin that we'd want to provide a strong and involved management, ano bang ibig sabihin nun, no? So, many managers will mistake the fact that millennials don't seem to appreciate hierarchy and authority, no? Na, kumbaga, it's a sign that they don't want to be managed. Pero, kung titignan natin, the millennial generation grew up with a high level of involvement and management from their parents. So, yan ang kailangan natin tandaan. Kumbaga, ang parents ng millennial are Gen Xers, no? So, they are used to being involved in parenting. Kasi nga, ang parent background nila are the previous generation. Okay? So, in terms of involvement sa management, what you have to remember is to have regular check-in and get feedback on their performance, no? So, that's one of the things na kailangan nating tatandaan. Pagdating sa mga millennial employees natin, no, hindi na mag-work yung every 6 months lang tayo nagbibigay ng appraisal or even feedback sa ating mga employees. Mas maganda for them, no, as constant as we can do, no. That's why kailangan medyo marunong tayo mag-coach, no, para dun sa ating mga employees. Kasi pag hindi, no, hindi nila na-appreciate yung feedback na binibigay natin sa kanila. Okay? So, we have to make sure that we are clear about the results you expect from the employees, no? And ano yung mga steps that they need to take para maging successful sila, okay? Again, don't let them think they can get there in 3 months, okay? Yan ang kailangan nating ipakita sa kanila. Hindi sila nagmamadali. Kailangan lang, kung ikaw yung manager, no? Sabihin mo kung ano yung step na gagawin nila. Provide a pathway to success. Show them specific actions that they would need and the metrics that you will measure them so that they will be guided. No? So, ang mga millennials gusto nila na meron ding measurement ng trabaho nila. No? So, as a manager, kung manager ka ng millennial, dapat marunong kang mag-measure ng performance. Okay? So, that's one way that you can be involved in terms of managing. Okay? Another, sabi nga natin, as a manager, we need to connect to a higher purpose. Okay? Anong ibig sabihin nito? You need to reinforce, no? As a manager of the company, kailangan mo i-reinforce yung company mission and vision. No? Bakit? Kasi yung company mission and vision, yan ang statement ng company na nagsasabi sa employee na ito yung reason bakit may kumpanya. Okay? So, kailangan ipakita natin yan doon sa ating mga employees, particularly the millennials, no? So sabi nga nung isang CEO, no, ng Deloitte company, which is a global consulting company, we need to do more to connect the dots for millennials, showing them the deeper global dynamics of the business enterprise. Sabi nga natin kasi ngayon globalized na tayo. So kailangan ipakita natin that we are living in a very globalized world. Okay? Ibig sabihin, wala nang masyadong border. Ibig sabihin, unlike before, no, when we started, especially in terms of HR, no, most of the practices were very Western. Pero ngayon, kung makikita na natin, very much involved na ang Asian community, yung even the Philippines is included. Okay? Now, another important thing for the new generation is recognition. Okay? So according to Burson Associates, it's an organization na for employees to do a good job, we need to recognize employees, no? Recognizing employees perform 14 times better than those that don't. So in other words, recognition, praises, and celebration are good for employees, especially kapag nasa sales ka, no? Importante yan. So that's why I always mention this, especially when I talk about the topic on HR, that yung recognition natin, wag nating kakalimutan pagdating sa aspect ng performance, no? So ang recognition, hindi natin siya ginagawang parang event, no? Recognition should be part of the culture. Ibig sabihin, kapag may mga nagagawang maganda yung ating employees, kailangan magbigay tayo ng recognition sa kanila, no? They need to be recognized so that they can actually be more motivated in what they're doing, okay? So now, the trick to getting the most out of any recognition is to execute it well. Okay, so paano natin i-execute yung recognition? Number one, okay, para makapag-execute ka ng effective or impactful recognition. Number one, mag-recognize ka ng mga meaningful things. No? Example, yung mga milestone, yung mga achievement ng employees, for example, you need to recognize that even on the personal side, you can recognize it. No? Now, second, make sure the recognition is timely. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, you have to make time to really recognize people. Okay? Another secret to recognition is to make it highly visible and public. Gustong-gusto ng mga employees nowadays na nakikita nila yung sarili nila in social media, in company profiles, for example, because they're being recognized. No? So, gusto nila visible sila in public. And of course, don't forget, make sure na ang recognition should be fair and consistent. Okay? So, ang mga employees din natin ngayon, lagi nilang tinitignan kung patas ba yung pagbibigay natin ng recognition. That's why, importante na magbigay tayo ng fair recognition and consistent recognition. So, creating an environment that rewards and recognizes the achievements of all your employees is critical to keeping them motivated. So, take note, all of the employees, not just some of them. Okay? So, kailangan meron tayong recognition program. Now, with millennials projected to make up 75% of the workforce by 2025, which is very near, no? So, we're 2023, no? The question is, how do I engage this new generation of employees, no? And again, as it turned out, no? What millennials want from their work is not at all different from what other generations wanted. And ano yung mga bagay na yon? Number one, they want to feel appreciated by their managers. So, again, walang bago, kaya kung titingnan natin, no? Second, they would want to have colleagues they enjoy working with kasi they spend most of their time doon sa place of work. That's why gusto nila, kasundo nila yung mga katrabaho nila, no? And number three, they should have a clear direction about what it takes to be successful. Ang laging concern ng current generation is, how can I move forward? No? Ibig sabihin, ito yung kakayahan ko. No? How can you show me the steps so that I can move ahead in my career? No? So kaya para sa mga current generation, ang talagang gusto nilang makita, ano yung career path ko dito sa trabaho ko? Okay? So those are the important things that we have to remember pagdating sa current generation. Okay? So yeah. So let me just check, no? Check ko lang muna, no? I hope, no? Let me just check. Okay pa ba tayo? Are we all good? Can you give me a thumbs up sign kung meron kayong napupulot dun sa aking share for today? Ayan. So tinitingnan ko lang kung buhay pa tayo at gising pa tayo this afternoon. Okay. So thank you. Ayan. So let me just continue. Ayan. Okay, so now it's very important that we also learn how to coach, no? That's why nowadays one of the important skill set, no, na dapat meron ang isang manager is coaching. Okay? So ibig sabihin niyan, it's a skill that a manager has to develop so that you can manage the millennials, no? So in terms of coaching and managing the millennials, importanteng tatandaan natin, no, one principle that you have to remember right now is that one size does not fit all. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, unlike before, no, na kapag minanage mo isang tao, isang klase ng style lang yung gagamitin mo. Nowadays, it's important, no, to really customize, no, your plan. Customize your managing of people. Hindi na pwedeng isang style lang ang ginagamit natin. Okay? You also have to spend time providing information to your direct reports and guiding them. Okay? And of course, you have to be impressed with their decision, no? One of the ways that you can coach a person is to allow them to make their own decisions. Okay? Kasi remember, no, kapag kino-coach mo yung isang tao, hindi mo pwedeng basta papakailaman lang yung decision making niya, no? As a coach, you are there to support, you are there to guide, but you are not there to make the decisions in behalf of them. Okay? Kaya kapag may problema yung employees natin, I don't always suggest that you provide, no, the answer to the employee. Bakit? Kasi meron tayo, 'di ba? Yun yung pagkakaiba, no, ng coaching tsaka advising, 'di ba? Ang coaching, no, for example, by just simply listening to a person, you're actually already doing coaching to that person. Kasi pinapakinggan mo siya, no? Which is different from advising, 'di ba? Yung advising kasi madalas sa atin, parang lagi tayong merong suggestion do sa person, no? That's why for me, ako as a manager, I always wanted to try na wag mag-offer ng advice unless, no, hingi ng tao kung ano yung advice na ibibigay ko sa kanya, no? If they would want to hear it, then I will try to give it to them. But if they just want my presence or gusto lang nilang merong makikinig sa kanila, then that's what I will provide them. Okay? So that's an important thing to remember. Now, sabi natin also, make work challenging, engaging, and fun. Okay? So that means, ano yung characteristics para mangyari to? Number one, dapat clear yung rules, no? Ibig sabihin, if you'd want work to be treated as fun, kailangan meron kang rules of the game. Okay? Another, kailangan clear yung objectives, no? Players understand what it takes to get ahead and to win. Okay? Kasi sabi nga natin, yung mga current generation, some of them are very competitive, no? They will try to really aim for the objective, no? Another, to make work challenging, give instant feedback. Okay? So players would want to know how they're progressing towards their goal at any moment in time. Okay? Now, remember the challenge here, no? The game should offer a perfect balance between being easy and dapat hindi siya boring. Okay? So, para hindi maging frustrating para dun sa mga employees. So, at the same time, kailangan may competition. Healthy competition would really bring out the best in this employee. So, multiple players can compete for the best score, no? Probably the bragging rights or just the thrill of winning. Okay? So, isang magandang aspeto ng trabaho natin ngayon is to make it fun and engaging. Okay? So that's another requirement, no, for the current generation. And of course, sabi natin, leverage modern technology. Okay? So paano natin pwedeng gawitin 'to? Make sure that you become app savvy, no? So kung meron kang mga cellphone right now, dapat alamin mo kung ano ba yung mga current apps na ginagamit ng current generation, no? So para alam mo na yun na pala yung in na pwede nating gamitin pagdating sa mga application, okay? Also, try to rethink your communication style, no? And by the way, no, tinuturo ko tong communication style in my training programs, and malaking bagay na naiintindihan natin yung communication style natin. Nowadays, it's important na maging flexible tayo pagdating sa communication style natin. And number three, no, nowadays, mas maganda, if you're managing people, make it visual, okay? Most people would like to make things visual. Ibig sabihin, may nakikita sila rather than just purely words or yung audio lang. So, mas maganda visual siya. Okay, now, kung titignan natin, in terms of the statistics right now, yung mga millennials will meet the Gen Z at work. Okay? So, ito na yung progression kung titignan natin. No? Dumadami na yung tinatawag nating millennials, and of course, the Gen Zs are also coming up into the picture. Now, the millennials are rising up to management roles. That's a, no, hindi na natin mapipigilan yan. So, ibig sabihin, no, the next managers would be the millennials. That's why, kailangan, no, turuan natin sila, bigyan natin sila ng opportunity, no? We should allow them to make mistakes, but we should be there to support them. Okay? Yan ang role natin ngayon kung tayo yung from the previous generation. Okay? Now, again, the basics between the two. So, tingnan nyo yung statistics. Ito yung description nung Gen Z tsaka millennials. No? So, ayan, malaki na talaga. No? Gen Z is about 23 million. Millennials at 80 million globally, kung titingnan natin. Okay? So, they are again born from 1982 to 1993. While the Gen Zs are born from 1994 up to 2010. Ayan. Yan ang mga Gen Z natin. No? And, again, the similarities between the two, pagdating sa top leadership quality, ang importante sa kanila, communication. Okay? Ang top employee benefit for millennial and Gen Z, work flexibility. Okay? Kaya maraming gustong work from home. Ayan. Another similarity for top reward or incentive, mas gusto ng Gen Z and millennial, cash reward. Ayan. For top social network, obviously, Facebook pa din for both generation. And the most desirable industry to be working in is technology. Ayan. So, yan ang similarities ng dalawang generation. Okay. So, again, ano namang differences ng dalawa kung titingnan natin yung current generation? So, sa leadership aspiration, no, high aspiration ang millennial, ang Gen Z slightly higher. Okay? Kumbaga, mas gusto nila mas mataas ang kanilang ano. That's why, if you notice, for some people who are applying at the jobs, no, gusto nila kagad mataas yung salary nila or malaki yung benefits nila. No? Now, for measuring success, for Gen Z, no, ang measure of success nila pag na-promote sila. No? Sa millennials, it's their respect from their colleagues. No? Yan ang measurement of success. For loyalty, millennials are less loyal. No? Ang Gen Z, mas loyal sila. Okay? For manager feedback, for millennials, gusto nila weekly feedback. Ang Gen Z, regular. As in, siguro, everyday. Kasi nga, may technology naman. Pwede kayo mag-text or mag-chat. No? Pag training vehicle, ang Gen Z, gusto nila project-based work. No? Pag millennials naman, gusto nila mga corporate-sponsored classes. Yan ang pagkakaiba ng Gen Z and millennial. Ayan. And of course, ito yung workplace behavior kung titingnan natin. No? So again, in terms of setup, no, ang mas importante ngayon is team over individual performance. No? So companies are shifting their structure from traditional hierarchy to flexible teams. Okay? So ibig sabihin, mas gusto ng mga current generation that they work in teams. Okay? So yan ang importante para sa mga current generation. No? Now, about 3 out of every 4 Gen Z and millennial will say that they are prepared to work in teams. No? That's why ang characteristics nila, they have the ability and then they have the flexibility. No? They have customer focus. No? They demand from younger generations and they're able to scale to solve bigger problems. No? And ang maganda sa kanya, the diversity of global teams and of course, the pressure to innovate, no, with the new generation. Yan ang mga characteristics ng team environment for the Gen Z and the millennial. Okay? So again, as I've said, no, pag tinignan natin, we have multiple generations at work. Sabi nga natin, working side by side by 2020. So nandito na tayo sa era na yan. So ibig sabihin, each generation will bring in a view of their world which creates both opportunities and threats to business. No? That's why kailangan meron tayong certain level of intelligence. So, yan ang reality natin right now. Okay? So, we have to remember that all generations want to be treated fairly. Okay? Also, generations would want to have work that provides personal satisfaction. Of course, employers who understand na personal lives are important. So, gusto pa rin nila yung employer nila naiintindihan yung personal life nila. No? Also, that work that is valued by employers and customers. And finally, also a clear sense of purpose from employers. Okay? Now, as I wrap up my discussion, let me offer to you, no, my 8 tips, no, kung paano tayo pwede mag-communicate with the 4 different generations in the workplace. So this will be my last portion for this afternoon. Okay? So ito yung mga tips that I will share with you, no, para mas maintindihan pa natin yung isa't isa pagdating sa communicating in different generation. Okay, let me start with the first one. So, tip number one is get everyone on the same page. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, dapat alam nung buong team mo kung ano yung nangyayari. No? So, times have changed. Not only that do we have computers, but we also have smartphones. So, ibig sabihin, it will allow us to communicate virtually from anywhere. Okay? So, many companies have adopted a business casual as their attire. Okay? So, for other generations, they may see this, for example, as being informal and sometimes disrespectful. No? But remember, as a leader, it is important, no, for you to set the tone and clearly outline the formality of your workers. No? So, remember, to get everyone on the same page, no, make sure that everyone knows what is expected of them. Okay? So, para hindi tayo nagtuturuan or finger-pointing, no, and there should be more room for collaboration and productivity. Okay? So, very important yan. Get everyone on the same page. So, that's one tip number one. Okay. Tip number two. Use multiple communication avenues. Ano ibig sabihin? Ibig sabihin nito, every generation, mayroon tayong kanya-kanyang preferred communication channel or avenue. Okay? So, yung mga veterans grew up with the phones, di ba? Yung talagang old style pa din. Millennials had their own cell phone while they were teenager. Baby boomers prefer face-to-face conversation while the Gen Xers prefer to speak via email or text. Okay? So, while you may have a hard-pressed time to find a phone nowadays, you can provide multiple communication options for your employees. No? That's why ngayon, importante, if you're in HR also, to consider social media to communicate with your millennial workers. Okay? So, hindi na unusual ngayon na nakakausap natin yung ating mga employees through social media. Kasi nga, part yan ng current generation na multiple communication yung ginagamit natin. Okay? So, that's tip number two for you. Tip number three, personalize your approach. Okay? So, one of the primary roles of the manager is to ensure that your employees have what they need when they need it. Okay? Sabi nga nila, a happy employee equals a productive employee, and a productive employee equals a successful company. So, one of the best ways to ensure that this will get done is to get to know your team as individuals. So, importante na makilala natin yung ating employee. No? Make it an effort to discover what works best for each member of your team and adjust your plan accordingly. Okay? So, sabi nga natin ngayon, hindi na pwedeng one size fits all, no, sa ating mga employees na hinahandle. Okay? So, that's tip number three for you. Tip number four is to understand value differences. Okay? So, alam natin na iba-iba yung ating mga work ethics. Okay? So, for example, yung mga ating mga traditionals or veterans, they view their work as an obligation. While for the baby boomers, they view it as an adventure. For the Gen Xers, who have grown up viewing their job as challenges. Millennials, on the other hand, no, view it as a means to an end. Okay? Ibig sabihin, ang mga millennials, nagtatrabaho sila because they want to buy the things that they want. Okay? So, understanding these differences and why they have come to that conclusion about their profession will equip you with the tools that you need in approaching each generation. Okay? Remember, we are all products of our environment, no? None are incorrect or none are perfect, no? We are just simply very different from each other. Okay? Yan ang tatandaan natin. Okay? Tip number 5. Okay? Be aware of the motivating factor of each generation, no? So again, while other members of older generations are used to coming in and getting the job done, no matter what, the youth entering the workforce right now is often motivated by consistent praise and guidance. Again, neither generation is right or wrong. Ang kailangan lang is that there should be a healthy balance between each viewpoint, and always remember the power of praising, no? Which is again a key motivator, no matter the person. So again, the key word here is to learn how to praise and recognize the person. Okay? So that's tip number 5. Tip number 6 is to ask before assuming. Okay? So encourage your team members to communicate amongst themselves. Rather than assuming the worst about their co-workers, they should converse and ask questions. Okay? So remember, as a leader, no, lead your team by example, no? Break down the typical stereotypes along the way, no? So, huwag ka laging mag-assume. Kasi pag ang manager laging nag-assume, most likely, sabi nga natin, when you assume something, most likely it tends to be wrong. Okay? So instead of assuming, ask questions, communicate to them, talk to them one-on-one. Okay? Para malaman mo kung ano ba yung iniisip nila. Don't assume. Number 7, tip. Be willing to teach and be taught. Okay? So, dalawang bagay. Importante itong number 7. Pakinggan nyo to. No? So, regardless of how much you have experience or how much schooling you have, there's always something that we can learn. Okay? So, today's generation can take some great lessons from older generations, no? Such as yung value ng face-to-face communication, no? And completing a project, no? But of course, yung mga older generations and baby boomers will learn the value of technology, okay? And how it creates a very different work environment. Yun ang dapat ma-appreciate ng mga current baby boomers and Gen Xers na because of technology, marami tayong mas pwedeng gawin, okay? So remember to always encourage growth within your team, as everything we learn will shape us into the type of individuals that we are and the type of work we do. So remember, be willing to teach and also be willing to be taught. So ika nga sabi nga natin, hindi lang tayo dapat yung magtuturo, kundi dapat tayo rin ay willing to learn from other people from another generation. Okay? So that's an important tip that we should remember pagdating sa lesson about generations. No? And finally, tip number 8, this is my last tip, is to embrace the differences. Okay? So sabi natin, while it may be very tempting to bury your head in the sand regarding the differences in the workforce, it is never a good idea, no, to be indifferent. Okay? Instead, what you can do is to acknowledge and embrace the differences. Gamitin mo yung mga tools and encourage your team to use these variances. No? So, ibig sabihin, bawat team members mo may kanya-kanyang strengths yan. So, gamitin mo yan. Okay? So, again, when your team sees you doing this, they are much more likely to follow you. Okay? Pero kapag lagi mo silang pinapakita na kakaiba sila, for example, or they're totally different from you, no, they will never appreciate you as their manager. So again, learn to embrace the differences that each of your employees are presenting to you, no? Because you'll never know, these differences might be the reason why you can become successful as a manager. Okay? So those are the tips that I'd like to give you and to leave you with this talk of how to understand yung ating workforce right now with the different generations. No? So just before I end my presentation, no, again, I'd just like to plug in lang some things, no? So I handle a consulting company. It's called Talent Reach, no? So if you'd like to get in touch with me, you'd like to invite me also for your talks or seminars and training programs, you can connect with us through our Facebook page. No, meron kaming Facebook and Facebook page called Talent Reach. We also can be reached through email, and of course we have our website, www.talentreachconsulting.com. Ayan. So with that, I conclude, no, my session for this afternoon, and as I've said, I'm now ready to answer some questions, no, or even create some discussions in the room. Ayan. There. Ayan. So, Neddy, let me turn over the floor to you for any questions or reactions.
Actually, sir, ang unang reaction ko, ako mismo, myself ko, ang dami ko palang nami-miss. Meron din akong mga nami-misinterpret na mga millennial and Gen Z. Kasi siya, yeah. Ano eh, hindi naman po nalalayo, pero
yes
din po ako.
Uh-uh.
Pero sir, di po ba may, first question lang sir, from may nag-message, ano ba itong,
yeah.
Ano ko lang, i-expand ko lang yung question niya.
Yeah.
Kasi, kung mananandaan niyo sir, di ba nabanggit niyo nga rin po kanina, nung nagkaroon na yung parang millennial bug, tapos dito po nagkaroon ng mga maraming questions, maraming mawawala, mga ganyan.
Yeah.
Being an HR practitioner na umabot sa ganung part, di po ba ang kadalasan nagiging concern sa isang millennial is parang mas, kung sa pagkakaintindi lang po namin, meron kasing mga millennial na ang gusto nila is, ano ko ba? Yung required na ibigay mo sa kanila because they are eligible of those benefits. Ganun kasi ang pagkakakilala ng ilan sa ilang
millennials.
HR sa ilang millennials.
Uh-oh.
Pero on my own side lang naman, sir, hindi lahat ganun.
Yeah.
Paano niyo po i-handle o paano niyo po kami mabibigyan ng advice na i-handle na hindi naman agad-agad ibibigay or hindi naman dapat kailangan porket millennial ka at alam mo kaya mo, ibibigay mo na agad lahat.
Yeah, that's correct. Siguro ang advice ko doon, no, it has always been something that comes up, no, every now and then, especially kapag pagdating sa mga managing the millennials, no, na ako ang principle ko lang lagi dyan is to balance both listening to them, no, trying to find out their point of view, but also making sure that they're accountable to something, no? Kasi sabi nga natin, ang iniiwasan natin are employees who become very entitled. So ibig sabihin, para ma-break yung entitlement, kailangan mo explain sa kanila na para makuha nila yung certain benefits or incentives, there is that sense of hard work that they have to produce so that they can be entitled to it. Okay? So that means na kapag, for example, nag-launch ka ng benefit program, no? So dapat ipaliwanag mo sa kanila, for example, yung tinatawag nating eligibility, no? Kung kailan sila pwedeng maging eligible for certain benefits. Kasi, 'di ba, pagdating sa HR, meron tayong mga tinatawag na benefits na upon hiring, meron ka na, no? Pero meron mga benefits na kailangan mo pang mag-eligible. Example, 'di ba? Let's say leave credits. So you need to be able to accumulate a certain tenure, no, para or number of months para makuha mo yung leave credit. So that means it's being earned, di ba? So certain benefits, for example, that they can enjoy, for example, has to have a certain requirement. Okay? So kaya importante for HR to be able to explain it properly to the employee, no, para makita rin nila na you are being fair to everyone as well. Okay? Yan yung mga dapat nating tatandaan pagdating sa ano. So to counter entitlement, dapat, number one, alam nila kung ano yung eligibility. Number two, that they also have a certain set of responsibilities na dapat kinagawa nila. no? As part of their role, as part of their jobs, no? So yun yung mga bagay na dapat i-focus natin sa kanila. Yun. So yun yung mga advice ko regarding that question.
Thank you, sir. Do we have any other question po?
Ayan, so I think...
Yes, Mama Mitch.
Hi, hello, good afternoon, sir. Di na po ako mag-video on.
Okay.
Hi. I would just like to know your insight po regarding parang a company devising parang customized benefit based on generation. Although I understand lahat naman po is parang nakaangkla tayo dun sa Maslow hierarchy of needs. Pero patulad po kanina, pinakita niyo top reward or incentive na gusto ng mga Gen Z and Millennial is cash reward. Pero other generation, hindi yan yung gusto nila. Ayun po, yun lang po yung question to. Would it be parang realistic or mag-work po ba yung parang customized benefit based on generation sa workforce?
Well, that's a good question. Thank you, Mitch, for asking that question, no? I think for pagdating sa benefits, no, we have to embrace yung tinatawag nating total rewards approach na tinatawag natin. So that means na nowadays people don't look at compensation merely on the financial aspect, ano? Although definitely for those in the younger generation, they really prefer yung mga cash rewards, for example. Simply because, di ba, as we have said, no, to understand the millennials, para sa mga millennials and the Gen Z right now, no, ang purpose nila of working is to be able to buy what they want, no? Because kumbaga, kung titingnan natin yung environment natin right now, there's so much things that they can try to buy with their money, no? Makikita na natin 'yan, di ba, dun sa mga sales and all, na they really are focus on acquiring certain things. So that's why, parang for these generations, definitely, malaking bagay sa kanila if the company is able to provide them instead of just benefits, more of cash rewards in that case. No? So, I would say, no, pagdating sa HR, pag nakikreate ka ng benefits, no, you can consider yung different generations. No? Pero, I think more than that, hindi lang naman kasi dapat generation yung tinitingnan natin, kundi yung tinatawag nating preference, no? Kasi pag sinabi nating benefits or rewards preference, nanggagaling yan on an individual basis. So, hindi natin pwedeng i-assume lang na, dahil millennial siya, ito na yung dapat ibigay natin sa kanya. Okay? I still believe na some of the other more traditional benefits will still be appreciated even with the new generation. Ayan. So, kaya parang for me, kailangan tingnan din natin yung preference ng employees natin. I think hindi lang siya base lang dun sa generational, by age, for example. It's more than age, kailangan tingnan natin yung gender preferences, in terms of yung kung ano yung what will suit them, no? So, hindi lang siya dapat on that particular aspect. Yan yung perspective ko dyan.
Sir, may pahabol ako.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Oh, yan. May pahabol.
Actually, nakita ko lang siya. Is there certain level daw po ba ng intelligence in every generation per employee?
Oh. What do you mean? Level of intelligence?
Yes, sir. Meron po bang certain level of intelligence ang bawat generation sa isang workplace? Or ma-differentiate ba natin siya? O meron na po ba kayong experience na na-recognize niyo yung level ng intelligence ng...
Okay. Siguro, how I would answer it, ano? Between the 1990s up to now, ang masasabi ko, mas naging aware tayo of the presence of what we call multiple intelligences, no? So, ibig sabihin, because of the multiple intelligences, you would see that, especially yung mga millennials and the Gen Zs, for example, makikita mo sila that they excel on other things aside from the typical mathematical and linguistic. So ibig sabihin, they have a certain aspect na they tend to become more creative, no? That's why sabi nga nila yung klase ng mga trabaho right now are not anymore the traditional jobs, for example. That's why ang ginagamit nilang intelligence is not the typical intelligence that they have, no? Some people right now are probably good at dancing, good at singing, for example. So these are intelligences also that has to be recognized, no? I would say yung mga, probably yung baby boomers and the Gen Xers, yan ang mga typically nakafocus pa rin sa IQ. Okay? Ibig sabihin, IQ pa rin yung importante sa kanila. Pero for the next generation, ang importante sa kanila is, of course, importante rin for them yung emotional intelligence. Kasi nga, most of them are very emotional. Susceptible sila to a lot of the things that are happening right now in social media, for example, di ba? So, madali silang maging emotional at some point compared to other generations na mas resilient, sabi nga natin, yung ibang generation kasi maraming pinagdaanan, no? Especially yung mga baby boomers na galing sa binanganak sila after the war, for example, di ba? So, alam nila kung ano yung paghihirap na tinatawag.
Nagre-request lang po. Can we please share again ulit yung ating contact o kung saan po tayo pwedeng...
Kung saan ako pwedeng makontakt. Okay, yes, sige. Sir. Ayan.
Gusto po ulit, meron tayo. Ayan po. Pinupost po ni sir kung saan po natin pwedeng makontakt,
sir. So you can email me at this particular email address, no? You can also follow my Facebook page, yung Talent Reach. Ayan. Kung gusto niyo ako maging Facebook friend, pwede rin. Ronaldo, that's my, yung Ronaldo Turla, no? So you can connect with me, no? And then you can also visit my website, talentreachconsulting.com. Ayan. So those are the ways that you can get in touch with me.
Sir, while nakapost yan, sir, meron tayong additional question.
Yes.
From Sir Harold. In terms of generation gap, hindi po ba nakakapagod or additional burden to have customized approach in terms of managing them like sa leadership or communication style? Hindi po ba makapag-confuse ito sa mga employees? And what are ways for us to determine the effective po ba ito? Salamat po.
Okay. That's a good question. Thank you, Harold, for that question. I would say yung pagkakaiba-iba ng ating mga different characteristics, for example, it's just but natural for us to have such characteristics, no? Pero I'd always believe na bilang isang manager, no? Ang definition ko kasi ng pagiging effective natin doon sa ating position or sa ating role is our level of flexibility, no? I'd also believe, no, and tend to agree that at some point also, some people might reach yung tinatawag nilang tolerance, no? Pag sinabi kong tolerance, there are really some managers na ito yung limitation nila pagdating sa pagiging flexible nila to other generation. And I believe na kailangan irespeto rin natin sila for that aspect, no? Example, syempre, may ibang generation na kahit na anong gawin natin na i-introduce or ipaliwanag natin technology, they will never really appreciate, no, yung mga technology na ginagamit ng current generation, no? But it doesn't mean that they should be alienated or be treated differently. Sabi nga natin doon, we all have different characteristics and we all have something to learn from each other, no? So the moment that we learn from each other, that means that nagkakaroon tayo ng mas maganda harmonious relationship na tinatawag. Okay? And naniniwala din kasi ako that conflict is healthy. Ibig sabihin kapag the more na hindi mo katulad yung hinahandle mo, no? Ako, no, as a manager, the more na hindi ko katulad yung mga tao na hinahandle ko, the more na nagiging mataas yung satisfaction ko kapag na-handle ko sila ng tama. Okay? So that is my challenge. Dahil alam ko na magkaiba kami ng personality, for example, pero the more that I can manage them and make them successful, that is my satisfaction. So yun. So yun yung tingin ko diyan, ano? So hopefully nakatulong ako dun sa tanong mo.
Hey, we have last question, Ma'am Mitch. Ay, meron pa lang isang message dito. I have, pardon? Sorry, medyo malabo ang mata ng inyong... medyo malabo ang mata.
Stop, sir.
I have noticed
okay.
There's an ongoing challenge in terms of retention for having a millennial workforce. Even for HR practitioners who are millennials. They don't stay long in one company. Could you give some tips on how to deal with this challenge in retaining millennial talents and what training intervention would you suggest for those managing millennial workforce?
Okay, that's a very good, very interesting question as well, ano? Na sabi nga natin, yung even the millennial generation, we're still trying to understand them, no? Pero I think, though, one of the things na kailangan nating tandaan for the millennials, ang importante sa kanila is, number one, they have a clear direction of the work that they do, no? And dapat maliwanag sa kanila kung may career path yung company sa kanila. So that's one consideration, no? Also, pagdating sa mga compensation and rewards, for example, dapat maipaliwanag mo rin sa kanila kung paano nila pwedeng ma-avail or maging entitled sila doon sa mga let's say mga rewards or benefits, no, na binibigay ng company, no. But more than that, no, I think ang nagiging cause din ng retention problem pagdating sa mga millennials is diyan na pumapasok yung gap between the yung mga Gen X manager and also the millennial. Ibig sabihin, yung mga current managers nila, nitong mga millennials, might not be adjusting well, no? That's why importante rin, no, for the company to focus on developing yung mga current managers who might be probably mga Gen Xers, for example, na mag-develop sila ng better kind of leadership style or supervision. Kasi sometimes, nagkakaroon yan ng gap, eh. Ibig sabihin, parang hindi na ma-manage ng tama yung mga millennials din, no? Although, admittedly, sabi nga natin na marami talagang demands yung millennials, for example, pagdating sa mga rewards and recognition, no? So, kailangan lang maging patient tayo sa kanila pagdating sa pag-i-explain kung ano yung mga pwede nilang matanggap sa company, no? Pero, I think, no, yung, you know, the phenomenon of job hopping, yung, you know, they go from one company to another, I think that's all, that's really part of the nature of that generation na they'd want to experiment and try out a lot of things. Which again, could be very malaki yung naging epekto sa mga companies kasi nga nagpapalit sila na nagpapalit ng employees. Ayan. So yun. So yun yung mga things that I think, no, ma-offer ko as a suggestions.
Sir, sorry, hindi pa pala yung last question. Okay,
okay. Sige, meron pa. Okay.
Meron tayong question dito from Ma'am Joanne. What is your advice on how to bridge the generation gap between employees? May mga program po ba kayo na masasuggest to improve harmony sa employees belonging to different groups?
Ah, right. Okay. Siguro, no, ang masasuggest ko would be programs which will encourage them to work together, no, or yung mga older generation could act as mentors, no, to the junior generation. Yan ang mga magandang programa na pwedeng simulan ng company na magkaroon ng mga mentoring programs, no. At the same time, dapat ano rin, eh, naniniwala ako na tulad ng sinabi ko kanina na meron kayong matututunan from the new generation to the other generation. So ibig sabihin, it's just a sharing of kung ano yung alam natin. For example, di ba, yung mga medyo, I would say, mga older managers, for example, dapat maging open sila to the new technology na pwede nilang gamitin, for example. So, yung mga ganon. I think, bridging that gap, for example, na sabi nga natin kanina, we have to realize that we're no different talaga. Kung titingnan natin, meron tayong mga common values and interests din naman. Kung titingnan natin, hindi naman totally magkalayo talaga eh. Kung titingnan natin, 'di ba? Kung titingnan natin, we all want to be recognized. We all want work that is meaningful. We all want na balanse yung trabaho natin, no? But the reality kasi right now is kung titingnan natin, iba yung situation na nangyayari right now than those that were experienced by other generation, no? That's why iba rin kasi yung nagiging impact ng current environment. No? Because of social media, because of technology, for example, that, no, in the older generation, wala namang ganong mga technology. Okay? Yun. So, yun yung kailangan natin maintindihan. No? So, there should be always that kind of open communication.
Ayan. May pahabol lang na question dun sa question na natanong kanina kung paano mag ano ng bridge. What if you do everything, mentoring, kinausap mo na tapos ang concern mo pa is hindi siya rock and file eh. He or she is a managerial
employee.
Nauna pa siya sa iyo being an HR.
Okay.
Kasi sabi niyo, sir, 1962, tama ba? Gen X?
Yes.
So, pareho kaming Gen X kung titingnan.
Oo.
Pero yung way of work attitude niya, way of ng mga trabaho niya, at saka yung how he or she manage employees, millennial or something, very, sobrang traditional.
Traditional.
Na sobra ding maramdamin pag ano, hindi ko na alam kung age ba yun o generation gap, pero how me as an HR personally, kaya ang magandang pwede naming gawin sa mga gano'n na, hindi naman po natin kasi maiiwasan yun eh.
Lahat
po kasi open for, yeah, open daw for communication, pero yung pagkakako, hindi po lahat gano'n ka-open sa change ng way ng work, ng way ng communication, ng way ng approach. May mga masasabi at masasabi tayo. Minsan hindi nga manager, minsan manager na hindi open for change.
Open for change, ano? Well, as I've said, diba, sabi ko nga, yung change kasi na sinasabi natin on an individual basis, malaking factor kasi yan is yung pag-turnaround niya, based yan dun sa kanyang sariling desisyon, no? Pero one of the ways that, let's say, kung manager yung sinasabi mo, ang masasabi ko is, number one, nowadays may mga tinatawag tayong mga coaches, no, or external na pwede nilang they can avail of such services, no. Another thing, no, na pwede kong ma-suggest dun sa mga medyo traditional managers, no, mag-take sila ng mga self-assessments like leadership assessment, personality assessments, for example, para mas maintindihan nila yung sarili nila, no? Because a lot of times, yung mga managers na sa tingin ko, medyo traditional pa din, parang they'd always want to feel na dapat sila yung iintindihan kaysa sila yung umiintindi dun sa tao nila. Okay? So, one of the ways na nakikita ko, no, that because I'm handling also clients and companies na merong mga traditional managers pa din, nakikita ko, nagkakaroon sila ng awareness, no, kapag binigyan mo sila ng mga sort of assessments and tools na kung saan mas nakikilala nila yung sarili nila, for example. And because of that, they tend to understand na may iba-iba palang personality na pwede akong i-handle, for example. Kasi most of the time, pag traditional manager, parang gusto nila na pare-pareho lang yung tao nila, for example. Isa lang yung style nila, no? The realization na hindi na pwede yung isang klaseng style, you know, will have to be a wake-up call for them, no? Ako, naiintindihan ko yung sinabi mo na marami, meron pa rin talaga na traditional managers, no? Compared sa HR na medyo mas aware tayo na kailangan, ano? Pero siguro kung titingnan mo ang difference natin, meron tayo kasing openness to learning, eh. Di ba? So kapag na-open na, sa isang manager na traditional manager, kapag naging open siya to learning, tingin ko magbabago yung kanyang style. No, yun ang very ano important. Kasi pag hindi siya na open sa learning, hindi niya tatanggapin na kailangan matuto ako ng ibang style. kailangan maging open ako sa iba, for example. So kapag lalo sila naging close, talagang mahirap na magbago yung style nila.
Sir, meron lang tayong last question tapos may isang request.
Okay. Okay.
So last question for this afternoon, what if career paths are clear and communicated well?
Mm-hmm.
But baby boomer bosses tends to promote less incompetent employees and promote on the basis of blood relation. Meron pa
okay.
Without considering the point of view of an HR and its impact on all employees. Meron pa palang ganyan, sir? Akala ko wala
yung ganyan. Okay, year 2023 na, no? Ito, maganda yung question niya, no? Which is, again, I would attest to this kasi nakikita ko to since I handle clients which are small to medium enterprises, and there are really some cases like this na nagkakaroon ng mga cases na napopromote pero hindi naman sila talaga qualified for it, ano? And ang importante pagdating sa HR, pagdating sa mga career path, for example, kailangan natin ipakita na yung proseso ng pagpapromote natin should be based on merit, no? Hindi na siya pwedeng based lang on dahil malakas ka dun sa manager, for example, kaya napapromote, or kung may relation, or parang may blood relation. So, definitely yung blood relation should be out of the picture kasi that is unprofessional kung titingnan natin. So, you really need to be able to promote professionalism in the workplace kung titingnan natin. So, yun, medyo mahirap kalabanan kapag blood relations yung ginamit na basis, no? Especially, kunyari, kung pinsan or kamag-anak, for example, siguro, no? Ako, naniniwala ako na dapat maging open din naman yung management, no? Na kumbaga, more and more, I think, mas maraming companies yung open sila na maging professional yung the way they handle their people rather than yung parang very you know, informal sila, or yun nga, kung may mga other people na kamag-anak nila na nagtatrabaho, they would prefer them rather than the others, no? So sa akin, that's not a good practice for management. Kailangan maging fair ka dun sa employees mo. Pag nakikita mo na nagtatrabaho siya, talagang may you know, meron siyang determination to really be promoted or to have a career, no, dapat bigyan mo siya ng pagkakataon. Dapat hindi mo ipagkait sa kanya yung ganong opportunity. Kasi otherwise, lalo na kung magaling employee, sayang naman kung mawawala yung employee na yon. Compared lang na para lang ma-maintain mo na meron kang employee na less competent, sabi nga natin. So dapat it should always be based on competence, not on based on blood relations.
Ngayon natanong ko, sir, kung meron pa pala eh. Kasi actually, way back siguro mga 10 years ago, may mga ganyan talaga kahit ikaw yung competent, pero dahil kamag-anak, anak, kapatid, mga ganyan.
Yeah.
Anyway, sir, last message or last suggestion, meron po ba kayong sasuggest na books or reference kung saan pwede kaming tumingin o makakuha ng information on how to better management multi-generational workplace?
Oh, okay. Well, siguro, no, there are siguro one or two books that I would recommend, no. The first one, which is parati ko tong nire-recommend pagdating sa understanding the current generation. Yung title ng book is called Drive, that is written by Daniel Pink. Okay? Si Daniel Pink is a New York Times best-selling author, no? So sinulat niya yung book, matagal na yung book na yan pagdating sa aspect ng motivation. So, and it talks about the current generation. The other siguro na I can recommend, not directly about the multi-generation, but more than that, no, it is a good book to read regarding mindset. No? So, the title of the book is Mindset. No? This is written by Carol Dweck. No? So, yung book na yan is very good kasi it's research-based. So parang kino-compare niya yung different generations, for example, kung paano mas maintindihan. And ang pinaka-importante na sinabi niya dun sa book niya is yung difference ng growth tsaka fixed mindset, no? Which is again the difference between generation, 'di ba? Pag titingnan mo, some people nowadays, meron sila ng fixed mindset. So ibig sabihin parang ito na ako, so hindi na ako magbabago, no? Pero most people right now, if they have a growth mindset, that is the chance for them na to learn something new, no? Hindi sila satisfied lang kung ano yung alam nila right now. They try to explore other things, no, that pwede nilang matutunan. So that is a good book to read, especially for, you know, the new generation. Kung mas maganda, mabasa nila yung book na yan. So those two books is what I'll recommend para dun sa mga nakikinig sa atin today. Ayan.
Mute po pala ako. Sorry. At syempre, hindi po magiging masaya at kompleto ang ating HRE knowledge kung wala tayong mandatory picture taking.
Picture taking.
Nakakalungkot. No, ang dami nang nawala.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Kanina po, umabot po tayo ng 50 via Zoom. And we have, on the Facebook Live, we have 22 via FB Live.
FB Live, yeah.
Open our video para sa ating mandatory picture taking.
Ayan.
Hi, Sir Rando. Hi, Ma'am Jo. Na-miss kita. Ayan. Actually, medyo marami tayong participant ngayon na first time kong nakita.
Wow.
Ay, may video na si Ma'am Mitch kanina. Alam.
Ayan.
Okay, Ma'am Mitch, can you please do help me? Ikaw magaling dyan eh.
All right, ma'am.
Ma'am Danica, ingat ka sa daan.
Ayan. So give us a cue kung kailangan namin mag-flash ng smile. Ayan.
Okay po. So we have two pages. So at the count of three, so smile po tayo. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, yung next page po. Diyan po tayo and at the count of three, mag-screenshot ako. 1, 2, and 3. Okay na po, Ma'am Nets.
Ganda ng ngiti ni Ma'am Danica. Ma'am Jem, ingat ka rin. Hi kay Ma'am Michelle. Naka-FB Live daw po siya. Hindi siya nakapasok sa Zoom. Mga ka-HR muli, samahan niyo ako next week. Yan. Pero bago yan, syempre, of course, I would like to thank sobra bonggang-bonggang thank you, Sir Ronald. Thank you for HRE knowledge. Guys, for free po ito. Talagang binigay po tayo ng oras ni Sir Ronald para ma-impart sa atin ang kanyang expertise at kaalaman tungkol sa ating topic ngayon na talaga namang ni-request. Ang ating topic today, requested by our mga participants. So, HR Calabarzon Group present this certificate of appreciation to Mr. Ronald F. Torla for sharing his invaluable knowledge and expertise as a resource speaker for the 79th HRE Knowledge entitled Understanding Workforce Based on Generation via Zoom and Facebook Live from 2 o'clock p.m. to 4 o'clock p.m. given this 18th day of February 2023. Signed by yours truly, founder Neddy Australia and my co-founder, Jorina Caparal. Sir, salamat po ng maraming.
Thank you also. Thank you very much for this chance. No? Ayan. So, invite mo lang ulit ako, Neddy. So, I'm just a chat away.
Yes, sir. I will keep it on mind. Lalo na po at nag-iisip kami ng magandang summit for HRE knowledge. Yeah. And sa lahat po ng gusto pa rin mag-avail ng e-certificate, ang ating para po makakuha kayo ng e-certificate, ang link po o ang QR code ay ipopost po natin hanggang eksaktong alas 4 ng hapon. At ito po ay open until 11:59 p.m. Ang e-certificate po ay ipapadala sa inyong email address after 2 working days. Kung bibilangin po ay ipapadala po yun sa Wednesday next week. Nakikiusap po kami na please ensure na ang inyong Google form ay ma-fill up ng tama. Kagaya ng inyong first name, middle initial, last name, and email address para po hindi siya mag-bounce back. Ang ating minimal fee is 50 pesos per attendee per webinar. We do not entertain e-certificate requests via email nor messenger. Ang ating pong GCash number ay 0919-009-6339. At syempre, iniimbitahan ulit namin kayo para sa susunod na linggo, same time, same channel, February 25, 2023 with Ma'am Daphne Granville on how to enrich multi-generational relationship at work today. So may connect po siya sa topic natin this afternoon. Kaya kita-kits po tayo. Iniimbitahan din po namin kayo sa ating first face-to-face HR Business Partner Learning Series of 2023 with Ma'am Vivian Cruz. Sa ang unang venue natin, kasi nga sabi natin, Calabarzon, ang unang venue natin ay in Cavite. Paid po ito. Alam naman po natin na meron tayong mga projects na magiging free. So ang ating pong kasama sa ating topic for the HR Business Partner on March 4, Saturday, 8:30 to 5:30 p.m., The Role of HR, The HR Business Partner and Its Focus, Organization Diagnostic Tools, Driving and Managing Change, and HR Analytics, An Introduction. At dahil may paid tayo, syempre hindi tayo mawawala ng free face-to-face HR Student Learning Series 4 of 2023 para sa lahat ng estudyante ng Human Resource and Psychology in Cavite. Yan, invited po kayo lahat to attend The Role of HR, 8 Hours of HR, The Employee's Journey, Competency-Based System, Philippines Labor Regulation Affecting Pay and Benefit, Managing Employee Discipline on April 1 from 8:30 to 5:30 p.m. To be announced po yung venue kasi naghahanap pa kami ng school na pwede pong mag-accommodate ng mga estudyanteng gusto matuto mula sa HR Calabarzon at kay Ma'am Vivian Cruz. Magkita-kita po tayo mga ka-HR. Muli po, Sir Ronald, maraming salamat. Sobrang thankful po kami. At magkita-kita po tayo sa mga events ni Sir Ronald dahil talaga namang may mga free learnings po siya at ako mismo ay attendee. Muli mga ka-HR, maraming salamat at magkita-kita po tayo next week. Thank you! Bye po!